CDN is an example of what is called an overlay network. Let me explain what an overlay network is. In the previous example, I said my node ID is 80, and the content corresponding to the key 149 is stored at my node ID 80, and this is something that you've discovered. And once you've discovered it, you want to come to me to get the content from me. But how will you do that? What does 80 mean from the point of view of the internet? As you know, the physical infrastructure of the internet works with IP addresses. But what you have is 80. It's not an IP address. And the operating system only understands IP addresses to route packets on the internet from source to destination. So we need, at the user level, because we are doing this sharing of content at the user level, a way of mapping such virtual addresses, 80, 60, and so on, to IP addresses. So we, as friends who have decided that, well, we want to form a social network to share information, content, and so forth, we've exchanged such mapping information and constructed a routing table at the user level. And this is what is called an overlay network, a virtual network on top of the physical network. So, for example, if you, using that SHA-1 hash, found that your IP address maps to node ID 60, you'll say, Kishore, my node ID is 60 and my IP address is such and so. So that is how I'm going to construct a user-level routing table. All I know is your node ID, and that node ID maps to some IP address. And I can use this correspondence between the node ID and the IP address to have a way of sending information to you. And maybe a friend of yours has exchanged routing information with you, and he has told you that his node ID is 80, and he has also given you how to reach him, given that node ID. And you've shared that information with me as well, saying that, you know, I have buddies, and these are all the node IDs of my buddies. So that's how I construct this routing table, which is really a table that consists of node IDs of my friends, and friends of friends, friends of friends of friends, and so on. That's how I construct this user-level routing table. Now, if I wanted to send a message to my buddy, let's say B, and his node ID is 60, because B has given me his IP address, when I send a message to node ID, I can convert that to the IP address, give it to the physical network, and it goes to the physical network, gets delivered to B. What if I want to send a message to some other node C? I know the node ID of C because my buddy B exchanged that with me, but I have no idea what the IP address of C is. But on the other hand, I do know that B has a way of getting to C. And so in my routing table, what I'm going to say is that given a name of a particular node, I know the virtualized node ID associated with that node, 60 for B, 80 for C, and I also know what the next hop is in the user space, in the virtual space of getting to that particular destination. In the case of B, I know I can directly send it to 60 because I have an IP address for B. On the other hand, if I want to send it to C, I have the node ID 80 of C, but I have no idea what that maps to in terms of IP address. I know that my buddy B has a way of getting it to C, and that's what I'm going to use. I'm going to say, if I want to send something to C, I simply hand it over to my buddy who is at node ID 60. So the routing table says, given a node ID, who's the next hop I should give it to so that it'll eventually get there? Now, the physical network, of course, is much more elaborate than this user-level overlay network. Now, for instance, let's say I want to send a message to C. His node ID is 80, but I have no idea how to send it to him except to know that if I give it to my buddy B, who's at node ID 60, he'll know how to get it over to C. So I'm going to send it to B. And when it comes to B, B knows from his routing table the IP address for C, and therefore he will send it to C, and it will eventually reach C. So at the user level, you can see that so far as I'm concerned, if my node ID is 50 and my node name is A, when I wanted to send a message to C, what I did was to send it to B, And it took two hops. At the user level, it took two hops to go from A to C, went to B, my buddy, and B then sent it over to C. So this is the user level traversal of the message. But in reality, under the covers, what is going on is when I send this message from A to B, it is going through the physical network and reaching B. And when I send the message to A to C, even though it is two hops over here, internally, in terms of the number of network hops that may have to be incurred in the physical network for the message to reach eventually the destination C, it might take many more hops. That's what an overlay network is. A virtual network on top of the physical network. And this particular overlay is a content distribution network because it allows content to be shared and distributed among a set of users who have exchanged information with one another so that they can discover one another, if not directly, indirectly through friends of friends.